And what happened? Women became homeless. Men and children scared. Homes were broken because of the wickedness of the devil. We're not here to do nothing but to repent on behalf of that great nation. We protect these leaders to go and make legal issues up in the capital, in the parliament. But I want to tell you one thing. Making things legal doesn't make things moral. You can't moralize things by legalizing them. The world is teared up by people legalizing evil. Slave trade was legal. Apartheid was legal. Segregation is legal. Even back in Kenya, you couldn't drink a cup of coffee at Norfolk Hotel legally if you had the skin of my color. And I'm coming to tell you today that evil is still in our blood. We were taken as slaves. Colonization came and took over. And all those are gone. But now the evil that is in Africa is more much than combination of slave trade and colonization. It's called poor governance without God. We are coming to repent. We are coming to ask God to give us kindness. We can't change our names and expect God to work with us. The Bible says, if my people who are called by my name, we all have come to a gratitude of repentance. And I'm calling you tonight for us to repent on behalf of those people, to repent on behalf of every arm of leadership in the country, the judiciary, the executive, every aspect of life in Kenya. Today, I want to ask you to repent. I want you to close your eyes. Today we came to humble ourselves. And as I join together with my brother Clarence, I want you to kneel down before God. Because the first step of repentance is humble. And we show humility. We ask forgiveness on behalf of our political leaders. In the name of Jesus Christ, we are coming to humble ourselves, Lord. Because we know that Lord God was great. You understand when we are going out and when we are coming in. We are sending you to that country. We are sending you to that parliament. We are sending you to that White House. We are sending you to that commission. Amen. We are sending you to the police station. Amen. We are sending you everywhere, Lord. Come on, bring your prayer. And you never want to speak to you tonight. Yes. Because we always take advantage of the privilege. And we will cherish that picture of that country. Yes. You've given us all great things to see. Yes. You have given us
darkness at all. If you claim to have fellowship with Him, yet walk in the darkness, we lie and do not live by the truth. But if you walk in the light as He is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, His Son, purifies us from all sin. If you claim to be without sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just, and will forgive us our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness. If you claim you have not sinned, you make Him out to be a liar, and His word has no place in our lives. My dear children, I write this to you so that you will not sin. But if anyone does sin, we have one who speaks to the Father in our defense, Jesus Christ, the righteous. He is the atoning sacrifice for our sins, and not only for ours, but also for the sins of the world. Father, we thank you because you are holy. You are righteous. In you there is no hint of darkness at all. Your holiness is unfathomable, Almighty God. You are so high and exalted, Almighty God. Yet, we are sinners. We are more sinful than we fear. We don't even understand the extent of our sin, Almighty God. When you look at how far you are from us, oh God, there is almost no hope. But because of Jesus, the mediator between God and man, our advocate, who prays in our behalf, we can come unto you, Almighty God, people from a nation that has walked away from you, from a nation that used to be called a Christian country, from a nation that has turned its back on you, Almighty God, and followed its own ways. We confess, Almighty God. We confess on behalf of the church. We confess on behalf of the church leaders in Kenya, Almighty God. When we hear scandals, when you hear of our churches endorsing politics, Almighty God, and you hear of our church leaders failing to stand up to the truth, failing to speak the truth to power. God, and we bring nothing but our brokenness to you, Almighty God, today. Forgive us for our country, Almighty God. Forgive us for our tribalism. We have hated each other in spite of the cross of Christ that makes us to get one. But we are Jews or Gentile. We have hated each other based on race. We have
and ask ourselves, Almighty God, what is really, really important? Is it party and politics or is it country? Father, I want to put country before you. We confess for greed. We confess for corruption, Almighty God. There are so many things, the list is endless. Yet, God, we don't even know what we ought to pray for, but your Holy Spirit intercedes for us in words that cannot be expressed. Holy Spirit, we pray that you intercede for us. Jesus Christ, we pray that, God, you advocate for us with the Father, because you are not worthy by our own righteousness, Almighty God. Forgive us as a country, Almighty God. May the nation of Kenya never be the same again, spiritually, Almighty God. Revive us again, Almighty God. Revive us again. Father, we don't deserve, Almighty God. The only thing we deserve, Almighty God, is punishment. It's due punishment for our sin. But we thank you because you don't deal with us as our iniquities deserve. But you're always loving. Father, we beg for mercy. Have mercy on us, Almighty God, in the nation of Kenya. Have mercy on us, the continent of Africa. Have mercy on us. We only ask for mercy, Almighty God. Hear us.
And may we also come back together one time just to praise God for the answered prayers. We are here with Reverend Sam to pray for peace and justice. The choir sang, Master, the tempest is raging. But the answer comes, peace be still. And so we have quickened our feet to come together as a nation because the tempest is raging. If you're back in Kenya now, people are not sleeping. They are crossing back and forth, some with ill motives. But we have come here to pray that, Master, the tempest is raging. And to the Master, thus the winds obeyed his voice, we want to believe by faith that the men of Kenya will also obey his voice. Yes. And so as we pray together, it's a prayer of faith that God is going to hear our cry. And though we are far from the land of Kenya, our hearts are in Kenya. And what happens there concerns us. And so together let us pray. O God of true democracy, we pray of justice and peace and love. We gather to pray for our country Kenya, its leaders and the people. May we all take up the challenge of building a just nation. Fill our hearts, the people of Kenya, with your spirit to be fully human, bringing justice and peace to our workplace, to our communities, and to our families. Give our leaders and the people of Kenya listening hearts and courage to act just and peacefully. A country where no one goes hungry or poor. A country where the different tribes and cultures love from above. Almighty God, guide the nation of Kenya into the way of justice and peace. And all this we pray, trusting in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Going for that justice that comes from you. God, we want to thank you that this time of campaigns, a time of election, and even after election, that your justice will be experienced in our nation, Kenya. And God, we want to cry to you today as we have come together as a people, as Kenyans, as a community here in Columbus. God, that may you send forth your justice to our country. We have sung that God, you are God of all creation, and that you bless our land. God, we are praying for that blessing upon our country, Kenya. God, thank you because you have good plans for our country. especially for the leaders. We want to pray, God, for good governance, that our leaders will work for the good of our country. And God, as your word says too, in John chapter 14, verse 27, peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you, I do not give to you as the world gives. And you say, your hearts must not be troubled, nor be fearful. And God, today as we are here, we want to pray that God, your peace that surpasses all understanding will guide our country. Peace during campaign, peace during election, and peace after election, God. We are yearning, God, for that peace. Peace that no man can understand. And that peace that comes from you, Jehovah God. Father, we thank you. We bless your name. May we all raise our voices and pray for peace for our nation and justice. Oh God, we thank you. We thank you, God. Because you are God who is ever present. God who never fails us.
Will you not judge of all the earth do right? The Lord said, if I find 50 righteous people in the city of Sodom, I will spare the whole place for their sake. Then Abraham spoke up again. Now that I have been so bold as to speak to the Lord, though I am nothing but dust and ashes, what if the number of the righteous is 5, less than 50? Will you destroy the whole city because of 5 people? If I find 45 there, he said, I will not destroy it. Once again, he spoke to him, what if only 40 are found there? He said, for the sake of 40, I will not do it. Then he said, may the Lord not be angry, but let me speak. What if only 30 can be found there? He answered, I will not do it if I find 30 there. 31. Abraham said, now that I have been so bold as to speak to the Lord, what if only 20 can be found there? He said, for the sake of 20, I will not destroy it. Then he said, may the Lord not be angry, but let me speak just once more. What if only 10 can be found there? He answered, for the sake of 10, I will not destroy it. When the Lord had finished speaking with Abraham, he left, and Abraham returned home. May his word be blessed. May we put our hands together for Pastor Esmond.
For the sake of the nation only, but because we too need God. And today we are here to present ourselves before God and ask God, could you please spare us the agony of nations? Because we have acted wickedly before you. We have pretended for quite a long time that things are all right. But it has come a time, for lack of a better phrase, for all of us to come back to our senses, to realize that our lives, our community, our city is in disarray. And now, for that reason, God has spoken and said, before I do anything, I have to reveal it to my righteous ones. For I, the Lord, I can't hide it from my friends. It is in my word, and I'm held accountable by my word. And therefore, I will come down and speak to my people. You are here today because you have responded to a cry of a city, of a nation, to the cry of a continent. That is in need of a savior. You are here today not because you did not have a place to go. You are here today because you recognize how important it is for you as a child of God to stand in the gap on behalf of the nations. Quite often, before God does something, Bible says, he comes to look for a man to stand in the gap. Haven't you read in the Bible that he came to look for a man to stand in the gap and he found none? He found nobody. And that opens us to the passage of scripture that we have read today. That the sins of Sodom and Gomorrah reached heaven. And he said, this is too much. People have become desensitized. Their conscience has been seared. They no longer become sensitive to what is happening. They think everything is all right. And the only thing that they are doing is to compare who is more sinful than the other. People no longer talk about sin or anything. It's about who is sinning more than the other, who is stealing more than the other, who is cheating more than the other, who is doing this more than the other. So the measure is on who is worse than the other. Because they're burning one another simply because of politicians. It is not the will of God that we live like that. Our congregations have become so tribalized that we no longer value the blood of Jesus. We only value if you speak my language. We have become so tribalized. What matters is if your skin color is black or white. It was not so. It was never meant to be so. It is not the will of God. A time has come, right from Ghana to Zimbabwe to Kenya to Tanzania, that we recognize that there is something greater than these things that we are calling that are of value. It is the blood of Jesus. And that is why I came to tell, what can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. When did we consider our tribes bigger than Jesus? I can only go to Goyi because I'm a Kamba. I can only go to revival because I'm a Kikuyu. I can only go to whatever because I'm a Makalenji. It is evil.
Evil.
It is evil. It is evil. A time of saying we are supporting our own, when that means we are supporting our tribe, it is a time for us to repent. We are united by nothing but the blood of Jesus Christ. There is no Jew, there is no Greek, there is no other nationality, there is no person from Ghana, there is no person from Kenya. We are one in Christ, and we have to stand.
and declare, nothing, nothing but the blood of Jesus Christ. How else are we going to demonstrate that we are children of the Most High God? We don't realize,
because the sins of the people have reached us.
And now I have come. But before I do it, may I have a conversation with my friend Abraham? And when there were three people, two angels and the Lord, the angels left, Abraham was like, let me have a conversation with you. I know what you're about to do. But if you found 50 people, would you still destroy? Would you destroy the righteous together with the wicked ones? And the Lord said, no, for the sake of the righteous, I will spare the city. Guess what? There were no 50 people righteous. So he says, what about 45? He says, no, I will spare the city. Guess what? There were no 45. What if you have 20? Like, no, I will spare the city. There were no 20 people. Don't you think there are people who confessed about God might have been there? But yet, there were no 20 or 10 people that would have been a reason for God to spare the city. And today I came to submit to you as friends that you as a child of God, you as a believer, you have a very divine responsibility to hold a nation. I say to hold a nation. So for us to be here today, I can tell you that this nation, the United States of America, has been spared the agony of nations because of the righteous. That nation, the Republic of Tanzania and Zimbabwe and whatever you represent today, has been spared because there are some God's remnants who are crying every single day that, Father, spare us the destruction of the nations. And today I ask, could you stand and be counted? The drums of war, you can hear them. You can hear them. I know we're here with different political persuasions. But I can tell you, if only we realized that we are one because of the blood, we won't kill one another. We will not kill one another. We will not start having a conversation. In this year, I've had an opportunity to preach in a different city, and I have been so amazed how many times I've counted. But when I tell people my name is Esmond, they ask me, what's your middle name? They are simply asking, what's your tribe? Yeah, they want to place me if I'm saved enough. That is the conversations we have. If every single time you hear somebody talking and there's no Luo around, they'll tell you, oh, that's just a Luo. We talk like that. Oh, that's just being a Kikuyu. I can say those things. You guys, you can't say it. And then we say we are going where? May God forgive us. A time has come. I say a time has come that we have to repent. A time has come that we have to choose who we will worship.
In the name of the Lord,
Thank you because of the nation of Tanzania. Thank you because of the nation of Uganda. Thank you because of Ethiopia. Thank you Lord because of Zimbabwe, of Zambia. Thank you Lord because of Canada. Thank you Lord because of every nation that is represented here today. We exalt your holy name, Lord. We pray that the altar of sacrifice of faith shall be lit up, and everybody shall offer the sacrifice of worship in the name of Jesus Christ. We shall never again be called a country of war. We shall never again be called a country of war. Because Lord, you have declared that righteousness will to exalt our nations. Father, we thank you not only to those that are listening to us in this great city of Columbus, Ohio, but we thank you, Lord, even for those that are watching us from the nation of Kenya, in other nations of this world. Lord God, we pray that your people are going to recognize that you have called us as ambassadors in this world. Your people are going to recognize that you have given us power and authority to destroy the works of the enemy. Father, we thank you because of the government that you have put in place, oh God. Thank you, Lord, because of every political activity, oh God. We pray that everything shall be under your guidance.
Amen.
Father, we declare that you are God. We declare that you are God. If there is there anybody in our midst that is sick, may your healing virtue flow in the name of Jesus Christ. May every sickness be consumed right now in the name of Jesus. I know there are people in our midst and those that are watching from across the globe that might have suffered a lot of depression. Their emotional hearts are wounded. And today we declare and shout as your suffers. We pray for the healing of the emotional wounds in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray that you lift the spirit of your people. Some of them, Lord, have been downtrodden, oh God. But I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that you remember mercy over your people. May your power and your anointing flow to break every yoke and to lift away every weight. And my God may set free in the name of Jesus. Father, we ask you that none of your children that came to
this. We are a divided world. And now we are in America. You might think America is not divided, but 10 o'clock, white go to their churches, blacks go to their churches, Africans go to their churches, Ghanaians go to their churches, Kenyans go to their churches, and actually we divide it even more. Kabas go to their churches, Kikuyus go to their churches, and Karajis go to their churches. It is a shame. It is a shame. Shall we pray for the healing? For the unity, because with unity we can command a blessing upon the nation.
Amen.
When we come together, could it be that we have been building a Babel for ourselves? Because when we start making a name for ourselves, we start making a Babel. Let us pray that God will bring together what the devil has confused. In you, who do not segregate, you don't look us from the lenses of where we come from. But Jesus, when you came, you even broke the wall of segregation. We pray that you break these walls that we have built in the name of Jesus. Break the tribal wall, break the economic wall. Oh God, break the language border wars, break the skin, the color of the skin war in the mighty name of Jesus, and unite us as one. And as we come together as a nation, together as a world, your name shall be glorified. We thank you, Lord.
He was the person who really spearheaded everything in coordinating this event. Pastor Esmond, we thank you. Thank you so much, and we thank the Lord. for allowing yourself to be expended in the ministry. There are two things that have been said. I won't talk much because our time is gone. About unity. There's this flag. Where are the flag? We don't have a Kalenjin flag. We don't have a Kamba flag. We don't have a Maasai flag. This is what makes us Kenyan. This is what makes us Kenyan. One people under God. And this is what we should strive to be one nation under God, to quote from the America's Declaration of Independence. One nation under who? Just one flag. Black, white, red, and green. We all know what the colors represent. We learned that in primary school. If you didn't, ask your neighbor when we know that. And this is what should make us seek unity. I've learned one of my weaknesses. Me, I'm a rural boy. I was raised up in rural Ukambani. I got to interact with the rest of Kenya very late in life. Until I moved to Nairobi, to pastor in Nairobi, Ziwani. I was pastor around Karioko, Gikomba, Ziwani, Isli. That was my area. And I didn't know much about other Kenyans. I only knew what? Kambas. And we had all, I grew up with so ignorant about other tribes. In Ukambani, we didn't have many people in the schools that I attended that were from outside the district. And then I came to the United States. I went to Ziwani and I started interacting with the church that I ministered to. Had all tribes, probably all the tribes of Kenya represented. AIC Ziwani. I started now learning, and I'm a fast learner, and I'm very curious. And as I get older, I'm finding that I'm becoming more curious and interested in people who are not like me and who don't think like me. And I thank God for that spirit that He has created in me. We have all these stereotypes that we grow up with, and you know, they bind us. They are like chains that, you know, hinder us from running the race that has been set for us, running the race of unity, of bringing humanity together in the name of Christ. I always make this joke. Someone made me laugh some years ago. We were gossiping about Pastor Esmond. And someone asked me, what tribe does Pastor Esmond come from? And I told that person, Esmond is a Kisii. And he looked so surprised and told me, then he is a good Kisii. Well, at least we thank God for bringing us as He has made. When we are together, we are stronger. And through Him, I've known so many Kisis. Through people like Bruce, I've known so many lawyers. I always tell Bruce, their family is my first experience with lawyers. I never interacted with in my rural Ukambani setting, I never interacted with any lawyer, with lawyers. We can be a family of God. And I always say that love is not quantifiable. You can't limit yourself to yourself. The more you spread out and reach out to other people, the more you become.
Thank you. to move.